when it's middle of the day, that can only mean it's midday with Jennifer Hicks.
Hello, hello, and welcome to Midday. I'm Jennifer Hicks. Today on the show, we're happy, very happy to welcome three of the most notorious arch-villain the world has ever known. Yorick Goldfinger. Stavro Blofeld. Emilio Largo. Yes. These three gentlemen have teamed up to write this book, Going For It, The Complete Guide to Global Extortion. Gentlemen, welcome to Midday. Now, each of you have come very close to achieving world domination, and yet, in every case, your plans have been thwarted by one man, James Bond. If you had to do it over again, how would you handle Bond?
I think, Jennifer, that there's one thing that Ernst, Ulrich, and I agree on, and we make this point in our book. If James Bond manages to infiltrate your complex and you capture him, just kill him. Yeah, just shoot him. You know?
Amen.
Yeah. Don't keep him alive for even a little while. Put a bullet in him and get on with your plan.
Yep.
There are fancier ways to kill him, but why risk it? If you're close enough to Bond to drop a tarantula on him, you're close enough to shoot him. If you're close enough to drip poison down a thread into his mouth, you're close enough to shoot him. Why make it complicated? Right. Shoot the bum.
But if it's... But if for some reason you decide to use a more exotic method of execution, say the slowly moving laser beam, stay there until he's dead. And for God's sake, whatever you do, don't tell him your plans.
That's right, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, we know you're dying to talk about it. I mean, you're proud of your plan. You've worked hard on it. And naturally, you want to talk about it. Just don't talk about it to Bond.
Well, now, why not? If you've subdued him and taken his gun away, where's the harm?
Jennifer, I wish I had a gold bar for every time I said that. And then Bond escaped with one of those little gadgets of his.
You've got to search him very thoroughly. Personally, I favor a complete strip search and rectal exam. But it's foolproof, and I know how much he hates it.
It takes a lot of the fight out of him.
Yes, it does.
Although sometimes you can miss the forest for the trees. This is a true story. Once I searched Bond, and I was so intent on taking all his gadgets away, I forgot to take his gun. He shot me in the shoulder and escaped. True story.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind him escaping if he just leave, but he comes back a little later and blows up the whole place. You know, usually just when you're about to launch your missile.
That's why we say in the book, keep the countdown short. You don't need a 5-hour countdown. It just gives Bond too much time.
Yeah. What's wrong with 3-2-1 goodbye?
Another suggestion that we make for the control room is don't let Bond near your self-destruct button. And whatever you do, don't label it.
Mm. Well, frankly, I question the wisdom of having a self-destruct button at all.
Amen to that.
Well, now, it must be tremendously expensive to set up an underground headquarters / lair.
Oh, forget about it.
Yeah.
Plus, you got to provide everything on site, like, say, a cafeteria. Otherwise, you got your people wandering down to the local village in their orange jumpsuits, having a few drinks and talking about the hollowed-out volcano they live in. Working.
Another problem we've had is price gouging. Once they hear it's for Blofeld,
and what about Goldfinger? I order a $600 incinerator chair, you know, for bunglers. And all of a sudden, it's $15,000.
Well, the key is to never use your own money. You see, for instance, when Bond blew up my undersea complex, I didn't take a bath. Crocker Bank took a bath.
I noticed in the book you differ on the question of sharks versus piranhas.
I know that Ulrich and Ernst are going to disagree with me on this, but I'm a shark man myself. I mean, they're big, they're scary, and you can see them.
I'm for piranhas, Jennifer, and I'll tell you why. Bond can kill 3 or 4 sharks. There's no way he's going to kill 300 or 400 piranhas.
Well, now, why can't you just use both?
Well, maybe. It's an idea. I mean, but shark versus piranha is a topic for a whole show, believe me.
Well, I am afraid it's going to have to be, because we have just about run out of time. But there is one thing that I'd like to ask you, Mr. Goldfinger. Yeah. I don't mean to pry, but I always thought you were German. You seem to speak with a New York accent.
Well, I was born and raised in Queens.
So you're not German at all?
No, that was a time when I guess I was running away from a lot of things. But now I like myself. I'm settled down, married to a wonderful woman.
Oh, right. You married Pussy Galore, didn't you?
No, her sister, Peggy Galore.
And you still love only gold?
I love mainly gold.
All right. What about you, Mr. Blofeld? What's next for you?
Well, I'd rather not say. Just watch the papers.
Mr. Largo?
Oh, hell, I'm retired.
All right. Well, thanks. That's all for today. Join us tomorrow at midday. I'm Jennifer Hicks.